हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड ऑल द बायोलॉजी स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस सेशन इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद द प्रीवियस सेशन ऑफ सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन, आई शैल डिस्कस सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन इन ह्यूमन बीइंग। द ह्यूमन बीइंग ऑल्सो कंटेन एक्स एक्स वाई मैकेनिज्म ऑफ सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन, बट इन दिस केस the genetic balance theory of Bridges is not applicable. Human beings, the Homo sapiens, have 23 pairs of chromosomes, in which 22 pairs are autosomes and one pair is the sex chromosome. The females have 2X chromosomes, and the size of X chromosome is that it falls in between 5th and 6th pair of chromosome. That is, it is a bigger chromosome containing more than 1,000 genes. The males have AAXY chromosomes, and the Y chromosome is smaller, but it occupies the position between 20th and 21st pair of chromosome. So it also bears a number of genes. It is not without gene, in contrary to the Y chromosome of Drosophila. When karyotype is prepared, these chromosomes are arranged in descending order of length, as described by J.S. Geo and A. Levhan in 1956. His arrangement was accepted at the Denver Conference, London Conference, and Chicago Conference, and therefore it is a standard karyotype. Now see the human karyotype of a male. You see, the chromosomes are arranged in 7 groups A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. In A group, only 3 pairs, 1, 2, and 3. In B, 2 chromosomes, 4th and 5th. And in the C group, it is the largest group, the X chromosome and the 6th to 12th chromosomes are present. In D group, 3 pairs, E group, 3 pairs, F group, 2 pairs, and in G group, Y as well as 21st and 22nd chromosomes are found. So the 22nd chromosome should be smallest in size. However, some scientists claim that 21st is the smallest, not the 22nd chromosome. Now, in case of female, the karyotype is slightly different. How it differs? It has 2 pairs of X chromosome. The last 2 chromosomes, which are placed here, are longer, and its position is in between the 5th and 6th chromosome. Now come to the other point. In human being also, XXXY mechanism of sex determination is found, but the genetic balance theory is not applicable. In human, Y chromosome is essential for maleness, regardless of the number of X chromosome and the autosome. It means, if there is Y chromosome, it will form the male. But if the Y chromosome is absent, whether there is 1 X chromosome or 2 X chromosome, the individual will become a female. So for the maleness, Y chromosome is essential. Now see one of the exceptional cases. This case belongs to a male suffering from a deficiency known as Klinefelter syndrome. These are the normal chromosomes, but the person possesses a pair of X chromosomes. You see, there are two X chromosomes in this case. These are the two X chromosomes. But how it has become the male? Because it possesses a Y chromosome. You see, here is the Y chromosome. So in presence of Y chromosome, the person has become male, though the X by A ratio is 1. Now, it is another karyotype. Here also, 2X chromosome and a Y chromosome is shown. This photograph is better because the bending pattern is sharp by using GIMSA stain. Now the person is almost normal. Everything is normal, but a little feminine nature may be found. In addition, the person has very small testes, hard and fibrous, and in biopsy, you will find that the person has either only a few seminiferous tubules or no seminiferous tubule at all. And therefore, he is severe oligozoospermic or azoospermic and mostly infertile. That is, he cannot bear a child. Now, it is another case, Turner syndrome. It is the karyotype of the person suffering from Turner syndrome. You see, all chromosomes are normal, but the person has a single X chromosome. In case of Drosophila and grasshopper, if there is single X chromosome, it should be a male. But here, it has become a female. But there are several anomalies. The girl has short height. You see another karyotype, second case. Here also GIMSA stain has been used and only one X chromosome is there. So she is the person suffering from Klinefelter syndrome and the height is how much? Less than 5 feet. She has short neck, thick waist, underdeveloped genitalia, low IQ, that is mentally retarded, and therefore abnormal in appearance. Internally also, the ovaries and genital tract are not well developed. So she is infertile rather sterile. What are the characters? A small mandibles, high act palate, low set ears, low hairline, bicuspid aortic valve, correction of aorta, ovarian dysgenesis, amenorrhea, there is no menstrual cycle, so infertile. Short, 5 to 4th and 5th metacarpal bone are smaller, widely spaced nipple, and lymphedema of hand and feet, that is, the hand and feet look swollen. Grasshopper, in case of grasshopper, AAXO is a male, and in Turner syndrome, there is AAXO, but the person is a female. So these two cases are not similar. AAXO in grasshopper is normal male. Here AAXO is a abnormal woman, infertile woman. In Klinefelter syndrome, there are AAXXY. The XYA ratio, that is 2:2, is 1. So it should be a female, but due to presence of Y, it has become a male. In Drosophila and butterfly, if AAXXY is present, they have gynandromorph. What does it mean? Half of the body is male type and another half female type. Now, just for discussion, I have taken example of the chromosome of melanrium. In melanrium, Y chromosome determines maleness, X specifies femaleness. X and Y chromosome in melanrium show different segments 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, controlling different stages of sex determination and sex differentiation. What are these regions? Region 1 suppresses femaleness. That is, if Y is present, the first region 1, it will suppress all the genes that are responsible for femaleness. Number 2, it promotes maleness. This second segment determines the maleness. Third governs male fertility. This third segment makes the male fertile. And the fourth homologous to the segment of X chromosome. This fourth part, the terminal part in X and Y chromosome, both are similar. Remaining portion of X chromosome determines femaleness. This fifth segment present in the X chromosome is for femaleness. So in presence of segment 1 of the Y chromosome and 2 of the Y chromosome, this fifth segment of the X chromosome would not function. In human being also, there must be some genes on the Y chromosome that suppresses the female genes, and all the characters of females are suppressed. There is no expression of the female character, whether they had one X chromosome or two X chromosome. In normal, one X chromosome. In Klinefelter, two X chromosome. But due to presence of Y, the female suppressor gene has set off all the feminine genes. And it has a regulating gene that allows expression of all the male characters, and because of that, the maleness appears. So Y chromosome is not without a gene. As many as 6 or 7 important genes have been described. But one particular gene, hypertrichosis, is known since long. The Y-linked genes are called holandric genes, and its inheritance is called holandric inheritance. That means wherever the Y chromosome will go, all the genes present in the Y chromosome will go to the child. Of course, it is the male child. Some of the important traits that are present of Y chromosome are ASMTY, which stands for acetyl serotonin methyl transferase. Second is TSPY, testis specific protein. Third is IL interleukin 3 RAY interleukin 3 receptor. SRY, sex determining region on the Y chromosome. TDF, testis determining factor. ZFY, zinc finger protein. And PRKY, protein kinase, Y linked. It may be autosomal also. So these were the important genes of Y chromosome. Now come to another point. In females, ML Barr in 1940, when she was studied nerve cells of female cat, found that in the nuclear membrane there is a dot like dark staining body. When she described it, it was named in honor of her as Barr body. Later on, Mary F. Leon in 1964 described that out of two X chromosomes in female, only one remains functional and another becomes secondary heterochromatin. This secondary heterochromatin becomes attached to the nuclear membrane and forms the Barr body. Mrs. Lyon hypothesized that there is a dosage compensation mechanism due to which whether it is male or a female, only one X chromosome remains functional. In females, therefore, second X chromosome becomes non-functional. Now, which of the two X chromosomes will become inactive? It is a matter of a chance. But this inactivation arises early in the morula or blastula stage. Once a cell has X chromosome heterochromatinized, all the cells arising from that cell will have same X chromosome in the form of heterochromatin or Barr body. They will not function. But in another cell, the second set of X chromosome may be inactivated and the first set may be functional. So there is a mosaic effect of X-linked characters in different tissues and organs. In human embryo, this inactivation occurs after 16 days of embryonic life. So some cells have inactive mother's X chromosome and in some other cells have inactive father's X chromosome. Now see, good cytological preparations prepared from the buccal smear, that is the buccal epithelial cells of a male and two females suffering from a normal and another suffering from super femaleness. In the first case, here only nucleus is shown. In the first case, there is AAXY. There is a single X and therefore no dark or Barr body is formed. In second case, the normal female is AAXX and she has one Barr body. If a person is suffering from Klinefelter syndrome, that is AAXXY, he also will have one Barr body. In the super females having three X chromosome, there will be two Barr body, one is here and another is here. So just by cytological preparation, a male suffering with a small testis, a small fibrous testis and infertility, whether he is Klinefelter or not, can be observed just by seeing the cytological preparation of buccal epithelial cells. Similarly, in Turner syndrome or in case of the super females, these cells can be observed to see whether a one Barr body is there, no Barr body is there, or two Barr bodies are there. So you have understood how sex differentiation occurs in male and how because of difference in the X and Y ratio, X and A ratio, there is no effect on the body. If there is one X chromosome or two X chromosome, the person will be a female. But if there is Y chromosome, it will convert into male. So for maleness, Y is essential. Thank you. Thank you very much.